Let's do this.
Oh, hey. Milk and Nuggets here. I mean, Adam with Milk and Nuggets. Oh, look, more Frank's hot sauce.
Because it's delicious.
So it's been a little while. Got some different dinosaur nuggets. What's cool about these?
New shapes. Like this dude.
So, I'm here drinking some milk, having some nuggets. I meant to do this one earlier, but it kind of seems timely, sort of, in a way. Oh man, I spilled barbecue sauce on my shorts. People are kind of like down on Far Cry 5 a bit. Oh, here's a brontosaurus. It's good that they change up the formula, you know. You don't want the same game all the time. But people are like, oh, I'm so tired of Far Cry 5 or Far Cry, a whole series. I kind of look at Far Cry the same way as my brother looks, or at least he did look at sports games, and that they're not annual games. They are, I don't know how to put it, but basically his philosophy was like, you get a football game, a Madden game, like every 4 years. Because it's going to be largely the same. I mean, granted, jumping from console to console, that's a different story. But you get Madden, and like every 4 years, you play it. And I feel like that's a good idea of Far Cry 5. Like, I'm enjoying Far Cry 5 a lot. I'm almost done with it. But I didn't play Primal, and I didn't play 4. So I played 3. I also played 2, but just a little bit. But, like, I won't go to the next Far Cry, like Far Cry 6. But I will probably do, like, a 7. So it's kind of like a game you play every once in a while. That way you get a taste of play. But it's not the same thing over and over again every year, kind of like Call of Duty. Every year, new Call of Duty. That is until they start spacing out Far Cry. Now if they start spacing out Far Cry a lot more, it'd be a different story. But Far Cry 5 is really fun. I'm enjoying it, running around. I'm not really paying attention to the story. Like, I'll watch the cutscenes, but that's it. I'm just kind of cool, running around, boom, explosions, you know. And I will say, Far Cry 5 has, even though I've unlocked so much more stuff, helicopters, wingsuits, and all sorts, I feel like the level of fun has gone down. And I don't know why. Well, I kind of know why. It seems like the pure chaos and randomness. Did I mention Triceratops? I think I did, but rawr. It's just the randomness and chaos of like the first couple hours of Far Cry 5 has fallen off. Because I remember playing and I recorded a couple videos, uploaded a couple videos, and some videos I didn't upload it were just like, I'm doing crazy things and just like blowing stuff up, and then some animal comes out of nowhere, or some, I remember there was time I was having, just randomly stopped in the street, guys just keep on pulling up, and there's a guy coming from a field, and this wild turkey vulture comes and starts killing him, and it was just like pure madness, and I was like, this is awesome, and now it's kind of like, I'm going around shooting some people. Oh look, there's a bear, but it runs away. Yay. Yay. The closest I've came to is doing the mission with Herc and Sharky. And their missions, when you do these side missions to get them as a character, they're great. The missions are like, oh, this is fun. There's a lot of awesome dialogue. They do crazy, stupid things like, oh, I'm gonna commandeer this truck, and then they shoot a rocket and blow up the truck, or this is great. But then I feel like once I've equipped them, they stop doing crazy things. Like, I feel like Herc doesn't rock around with his rocket launcher anymore. Or I don't feel that Sharky has his flamethrower out ever. He just walks around with a shotgun and kind of like, oh, okay, you're not as fun now. That's a shame. But otherwise, I'm enjoying Far Cry 5. It's fun. I'm almost done with it. I don't know if I'll do any. I hear PvP's awful or multiplayer. Not sure if I'll try that. Not sure if I'll even dabble in co-op. I will jump into arcade, but I'm especially looking for the season pass. Go to Mars, fight some aliens. How can you not like that? Yeah, I don't know. People are saying it's average or awful, but the gunplay is really great. I feel like it's really well done. Obviously, a lot of people work on it, a lot of money spent on it. Sure, it doesn't have all the physics as Far Cry 2. I feel like outside of some of like fire and trees destruction, it's good enough, because I mean, there's not a whole lot of shanty walls to shoot through. Yeah, it's fun. And takes jabs at Trump in middle America. Hooray, if that's your thing. Far Cry 5, that was the main gist of this, because I really had this idea and thought you should hear it. I guess the only other thing that's really on my mind is I enjoy The Last Jedi. I'm really interested in, there's a special feature, not a special feature, but there's a, basically they included a special way to watch the Last Jedi, and that is no sound effects, no dialogue, all it is the music. So you can watch all of Last Jedi with nothing but the John Williams score setting the mood. I'm really curious about that because, like, the director is super happy that they're able to get that into the movie. Or the product. But the one caveat, which is kind of annoying, which now I'm just like, I don't know if I'm even going to bother. It's not on a DVD. It's not on a Blu-ray. Redeem your digital copy of the movie on Movies Anywhere. And then you go on the Movies Anywhere app, and then there's, like, under, like, musics and sounds, you can watch the whole movie there on your digital device. So I guess it's not as big a deal if you have a smart device attached to your computer of some sort. Not computer, but monitor. Or if you watch everything on your computer. But as for me, who watch Blu-rays or stream stuff, there's no Movies Anywhere app on my PS4. So I'm kind of like, what am I supposed to do? So it's kind of annoying. I can't easily watch it. Like, maybe if I watch it on a plane, it would be easier. To be fair, Rian Johnson did say he was kind of annoyed that you had to jump through these hoops to do it. Oh no, last nugget! So, yeah, but maybe I get a new TV soon. There'll be a smart TV and I'll have Movies app on it. No, I don't think Movies Anywhere is on any smart TVs. The Disney domination hasn't fully taken over yet, and we're paying the price. How awful, right? Very delicious. I know you'll hate to hear this, but I did attempt to make a different Milk and Nuggets episode. But right before I was getting everything set up to do the same, like, Far Cry topic and whatnot, I realized I had no milk. And the nuggets were already in the oven, so I didn't want to burn down the place. I guess, if it was really quick, how long would it take until they'd catch fire? I guess how long would it take would it burn to cause enough smoke to set off the smoke alarm? I could have gotten milk in time, but I didn't want to risk it. I want to keep it safe so I can bring you even more nuggets in the future. But it's probably better because the nuggets weren't very good. And I suppose you would want to know that. They're like some kind of honey battered nuggets I picked up from the store to try out. They weren't good. Maybe I thought I've had honey battered. I will do better to get you your nuggets with milk of all kinds. Doesn't hurt that got a Costco box of chicken nuggets. So I'll be stocked for a while. Better believe it. Anyways, follow Milk and Nuggets. And yum.